3 to-do list apps, 1 winner. Which one out of Asana, TickTick, and ToDoIst will win this battle? God, it's not that serious. I keep doing this thing where it's like it's just a comparison of software and act like it's this whole big thing. Let's go into the video. First and foremost, we have Asana. So Asana actually was the first ever software that I was introduced to that was a task management software. Back in my first internship in 2019, I used it. And at the time, since I didn't know that there was a way to download it and I didn't really know how to use it that well because I didn't try, I thought it was bad. But it's not. There is unlimited tasks, projects, messages, activity log, which is a big one when you compare it to ToDoIst. And you can collaborate with up to 15 teammates, change to a bunch of different views, integrate it with time tracking apps, and there are a bunch of other free integrations as well. Now, the premium version is the most expensive by far on this one. However, it is mainly because it is a team-based software first. You can use Asana for individual task management, but I would recommend focusing on this as a team option for to-do list and project management. For that reason, you'll get a timeline view, a workflow builder, a bunch of different dashboards, better search, and forms. Now, the pricing side for Todoist and TickTick is much cheaper. And the middle option here is Todoist, which has a free plan that allows you to have unlimited tasks, but only a few projects and some collaborations per project, very small file uploads, a few filters, and 1 week of activity history. Now, with the pro version, you have pretty much unlimited projects, 25 collaborators per project, 100 megabyte file uploads, which if you noticed, Asana had the same size on the free plan. 150 filters, which is pretty much unlimited. Reminders, unlimited activity history, which once again, the free plan had that for Asana. And then the business version is pretty much the pro plan with the ability to have a team inbox, team billing. Now, TickTick is the cheap one and is personal task management only focused. It is less than $2.50 a month or $27.99 for the year. And what you get for the upgraded version is a full-fledged calendar view, which has integrations with Google Calendar, customizing filters, and you can view previous changes for all tasks. So it has an activity history situation and you have more tracking of progress and whatnot. It also gives you premium white noise. And this is cool since TickTick has a Pomodoro timer on the application, which a lot of people are a fan of. Considering along with that, on the pro version, you get estimated Pomodoro timers that you can put on your different tasks. So diving into the features of Asana, this one is definitely the most dashboardy and high level sort of application on this list. I think if we just go into the My Tasks section, you'll see that it has a little bit more of a robust option here since it can switch between list, board, calendar, and this is not something that any of the other apps have. You see a month view here, which is really nice and something that I really wish that task management apps like Todoist had. And then if you open one of these tasks, it has the option to put subtasks on there. It has priority just like with Todoist. It has a project capability. It has the ability to change due dates, set it to repeats. Now, this is all fine and dandy, and I do really enjoy this because you can also share this stuff really easily by linking this board with other people. There are really nice sorting options, filtering options, the ability to customize this. It is the only one of the software that has the option to have rules. So for example, if you change a priority updated to high, then you would add certain people to it. So say a due date is approaching, you can move it into a certain section, like a high priority section. So let's say this one, this rule basically says move to do section when it's getting close. And the integrations on this are definitely the largest. You saw 100 plus. That's not something that you have in things like Todoist and TickTick. All of them pretty much have Gmail capabilities and the ability to integrate with a lot of those kind of applications. But this one's definitely going to have the most. And you can even set up dashboards in Asana, which is not something you can do in the other platforms that I'm comparing it to. This is really cool to just see what your different incomplete tasks are, what's overdue. From a team management perspective, this really gives a nice overview for a manager to look at this kind of stuff. Now, going back to the list section, this is a really decent way to look at different projects and tasks. But what I like about Todoist is the ease of use regarding input of task management. It has a list view, it has a board view, it has recurring tasks, it has filters, it has a lot of the same stuff as Asana, but not like that high level. But just the ability to have natural language processing that's this nice is really good. This is a work task that is for a video that I'm recording at 5 p.m. So I got all that natural language processing just with my keyboard, and I can even do a really quick showcase of the fact that I'm here and I'm pressing the shortcut to pull that up, and I can make a task at 3 p.m. today and move this to a specific inbox, move this to the team inbox, move this to the specific project, change the labels, change the priority. I mean, I can obviously do P2 or P1 right here. And that's one of the best parts about ToDoIst. You can just really do things nice, quick, and easy. It's not as overwhelming as something like Asana, in my opinion, and even the mobile app's better. You can switch and group things by project, default, due date. My favorite thing to do is go into the today view and have it in my TTP method, which basically does a top down of the different priorities of my life and then sorts it by the time. If I press Shift V, it'll go back and forth between the list and the board view, which is really nice. And overall, I like the fact that this application is a little snappier than Asana and is just pure good personal task management. I actually have a course on ToDoIst if you want to check that out in the link in the description. Now, TickTick is not as quick from a input base when it comes to allowing you to do things like you can in ToDoIst. However, it does have a lot of the same views regarding today, next 7 days, and inbox, and you can have different tags and lists that happen. I would say the main differentiations for this is that it is not as snappy regarding input of tasks, but you can see things better on the pro version. I'd have a calendar that's fully integrated, whereas ToDoIst does not have it. I have a habit tracker, which is there. I have an Eisenhower matrix, which is just another option for anybody who wants to manage their time like that. The search function is pretty nice. There is a Pomodoro timer. And if I go to settings, I can turn on the focus timer. So it allows me to have a different shortcut for it. Control-Alt-P would bring that up, and it allows me to have a Pomodoro timer pinned onto my desktop, which is really nice. And I think it's cool it has a completely separate habit tracker. This is probably the most diverse personal task management software out of these three. And if you want to have that calendar view, a habit tracker, and a Pomodoro timer in one application, upgrading to the pro version for this will be the cheapest option. Now, from an integration side of things, TickTick is in last place. And what I mean by that is it literally has the least amount of integrations that go along with it. When you look at daily planner apps, it's probably not gonna have a TickTick integration with it. It does have some things with like Gmail, and you can do voice task capture with things like Google Assistant and shortcuts. You can use it with Outlook, Gmail, and Zapier, which is a catch-all situation to just say basically there might be an integration on here that you can use with it. But for truly built-in integrations, ToDoIst is in second place. It is right around the same amount of integrations as Asana when it comes to integrating with daily planner apps. There's Akiflow, Friday, Morgan, which is another one, Sansama, and it even has a chat app that can integrate with it that is from the same exact company in Twist. And then the Google Calendar sync for this is really nice. So you can have tasks come in from a two-way sync, and even have it so that if I finish the task in ToDoIst, it would delete this off the calendar. This is a way you can time block, which I think is pretty cool with ToDoIst. However, the sheer number of integrations that I showed earlier in Asana will tell you that it has a much better integration portfolio. When you go to their website, there's even Adobe Creative Cloud stuff, which is not a very common thing. Integrating with Salesforce, Microsoft Teams, Tableau. This just allows this application to really have the ability to work well with teams. And the sheer quantity of this integration number is going to be higher, but it all matters on what is going to serve you the most. Because if you're trying to use it with a daily planner app, Asana or ToDoIst will have a similar number of integrations. But overall, my verdict is this. I think if you want to go with a personal task management software that is going to have the most integrations, be paired with Google Calendar well, I would go with ToDoIst. It's my favorite productivity app of choice that isn't Notion. And Asana would be my first place one for businesses. Now, if you really like the fact that there's a Pomodoro timer and there's an Eisenhower matrix and stuff like that, go with TickTick. It's really good on the pro version. I would recommend trying it out on free and then seeing if you want to upgrade for that calendar view, because that's really nice. On the go, TickTick will probably be your best option because its voice capture for tasks is better than ToDoIst, in my opinion. And then for Asana, it's probably great if you're the leader of a team who wants to have a nice, simple task management app with a lot of integration capabilities. So all of these are going to be different for what your needs are. So I hopefully broke that down as well as I could. And you could check out this video to see how you can improve your productivity even more.